Commander, you're needed in the Alliance War Room for a status update.
The Eternal Alliance is getting stronger every day, Commander. Worlds across the galaxy have sent us tribute, and everyone respects your authority as Empress. Well, almost everyone. There's another rebellion on Zakuul. What are your orders?
Send in our agents, and try to end this without bloodshed.
They'll be on the ground within the hour.
You're holding out on me, Theron. What's the status of our mission to Iokath?
I was saving the best for last. Lana should be closing in on the superweapon right about now.
Come in, Lana. How's the radiation sickness treating you?
It's nothing I can't handle. Isn't that right, C6? You heard the droid.
Mm-hmm. Lana equals full of herself.
Focus on the mission. Have you found the superweapon, Lana?
According to the intel we received, it should be just up ahead. Stand by. Target located. Commencing scan. Power levels are off the charts, and rising by the second. Incredible.
Contact!
Lana, what's happening?
I've got company.
What's the Republic doing here? The Sith Empire? They must be after the superweapon.
Get Lana back online. Hurry!
Working on it!
Don't worry, I lost them.
Lost who?
The Sith Empire and the Republic. They're on Iokath, and they appear to be fighting for control of the superweapon.
Iokath is massive. There's no way we all happen to find the superweapon at the exact same time.
Agreed. The timing is just too perfect.
So it's fate, chance, or plain old bad luck. Either way, we've got a superweapon to deal with.
According to my scans, it's more powerful than anything we've ever encountered.
More powerful than the Eternal Throne?
Quite possibly. If the Republic or Empire claim it, they would usurp the Eternal Alliance as the dominant power in the galaxy. The fallout would be catastrophic.
Then we have no choice. We can't let this weapon fall into the wrong hands.
How should we proceed, Commander?
We'll meet you on Iokath, Lana. Head for the fleet spire and start clearing a landing zone.
Understood. I'll see you soon.
Ships of the Eternal Fleet, converge on Iokath immediately and await my orders. We have a war to win.
Thank you.
Hello, Iokath. You're looking as dangerous as ever.
Something's wrong. The Imperial and Republic fleets aren't attacking each other.
No. Something is scrambling our weapon systems. It's coming from the planet's surface, near the superweapon. The Eternal fleet's offline, Commander. They can't help us.
Tell the Gemini captains to find a workaround. In the meantime, we'll head to the surface and establish a landing zone.
Good call. If there's any way to help our fleet, we'll find it on Iokath.
Section authorized.
Don't say I never did anything for you.
Eliminate threats.
No time like the present.
Restore balance.
Lana, we've landed on Iokath.
Perfect timing. Meet me at these coordinates and watch out for droid sentries.
Clear the area. We need the fleet spire safe before we make camp here.
Understood. May the Force ever serve you.
Commander, welcome back to Iokath.
I hate it when work keeps us apart.
At least the reunions are all the sweeter.
You didn't tell us you had company.
Our trigger-happy friend sent these assassins, so I took them captive.
I told you I'm no assassin! I've come to deliver a message from the Republic.
And you are?
Captain Ilara Dorn of the Republic. It's an honor to meet you, Commander.
Careful, Commander. You'll slip on the fawning Captain Slobber.
Who are you?
Major Quinn. Advisor to the Empress and loyal servant of the Sith Empire. Like Captain Dorn, I come bearing a message.
Supreme Commander Malcolm wants a word with you, in private.
Empress Asena requests the same, but unlike Malcolm, she's open to a group conference.
Get your leaders on the line, both of them. It's about time we sort out this mess.
Right away.
Thank you for extending the Empire this honor, Commander.
The Republic's glad to see you, and my son, on Iokath.
Keep me out of this, Malcolm.
Enough!
Supreme Commander Malcolm, Empress Asena, your armies have started a war over a superweapon of immeasurable power.
Why would you risk everything over a single weapon?
I take full responsibility for the Republic's actions, but I won't apologize.
This ought to be rich.
It's no secret the Eternal Empire nearly wiped out the Republic. We're struggling to rebuild and protect ourselves. The superweapon on Iokath is the key to the Republic's survival. And I'll be damned if I'm gonna watch it fall into the Empire's treacherous hands.
I didn't come here to be insulted.
Choose your next words carefully, Malcolm.
I know you've spilled your share of Republic blood, but that's in the past.
Join forces with the Republic. Help us defeat the Empire, and we'll share access to the superweapon and all of Iokath.
Malcolm's your father, Theron. What do you make of his offer?
He's right about the Republic. Valen nearly broke them. They need this.
The Empire suffered too.
We alone supported your battle against Valen, and we paid for it dearly. Now the Republic wants to deliver the killing blow.
You once sat beside me on the Dark Council. Now you can return to your roots.
Help us crush the Republic threat. Once they fall, our empires can both partake in the spoils of Iokath.
You've worked with the Empire more recently. What do you make of Asena's offer?
We've already allied with the Empire. If we turn against them now, what message does that send to the rest of our followers?
It tells them we don't honor agreements with traitors. Don't forget, she trespassed on Iokath without your permission.
A small transgression.
If I had to choose, I would join forces with the Empire.
The Republic's a safer bet.
The choice is yours, Commander. Who shall we side with?
We will ally with the Sith Empire. A wise choice.
Sith never listen to reason. Dorne, do it!
For the Republic!
She got away.
We'll deal with her later.
Commander, the Republic has launched their attack!
Fight back with everything you've got. We're on our way. Lana, Major Quinn, defend the fleet's fire while we hold off the Republic.
May the Force serve us all. The Empire needs you, Commander. Major Quinn and I will defend this position.
The Republic thinks they can defeat us. Impress them with the might of the Empire and the Eternal Alliance. We have the Republic on the run. Let no one escape.
It's been far too long since I've spilled Republic blood. I haven't had this much fun since our time on Droman Kaas. And once again we stand triumphant against our foes. We have secured our base and sent the Republic troops whimpering back to their master.
The closer our relationship, the more impressive the results.
Our combined power will fill Malcolm with terror. If I know the Supreme Commander, he's already plotting the Republic's next move.
Strike teams Aurek and Greg suffered heavy losses. The survivors await your orders.
Asena must be loving this, but her victory belongs to her ally. You compiled a report on the Alliance Commander. What's your recommendation?
She's a hardened veteran with extensive personnel and resources. Even with our numbers, I doubt our chances in a head-to-head battle. Asymmetrical tactics would be best. A surprise attack, surgical and precise.
Then we'd better shock the Alliance Commander. Gather your top engineers and rally the troops. I'm coming to Iokath.
What are we looking at?
The Republic has erected a formidable base. Their defenses are impressive, but they lack the supplies needed for a long campaign. If we lay siege to Malcolm's base, we can suffocate the Republic offensive and win the war.
You know your father better than any of us. How do we break him?
Malcolm and I aren't close, but he's not hard to read. He thinks like a soldier, measures his life in ground lost and battles won. Every loss is an opportunity.
He's going to prey on our overconfidence.
And then spring his trap right when we let our guard down.
If I were Malcolm, I'd stage the ambush the second we enter his base. We'd be trapped inside, running blind, and locked in the Republic's sights.
What's stopping us from making a run on the superweapon?
Several thousand Republic troops.
They'd corner us before we gained access. If we want that superweapon, we have to take the base down first.
Indulge me for a moment. My scouts recently found a weapons factory. It's guarded by a host of Iokath droids and filled to the brim with dangerous toys. What do you say we plunder the factory, then use what we find to annihilate Malcolm's base?
Will Iokath's weaponry be enough to break your father's defenses?
Malcolm won't see it coming, which means it's the best shot we have.
Coordinate with Lana and get ready to attack the base. Theron and I will take the weapons factory.
Commander, I've received a transmission. It's heavily encoded, but it appears to be from Scorpio. She says only the gods can give us back full control of the Eternal Fleet. As to what that means, your guess is as good as mine.
Is that what I think it is?
One of Iokath's original creators. Looks like it's been dead for centuries.
Let's hope it stays that way.
Even all this time later, I can still feel the agony of its final moments. Something horrible happened here.
Thanks for the nightmare fodder. All right, buddy. Let's see what you know about these weapons.
Iokath's even more impressive in person.
Its technologies will defend the Republic soon enough. We've nearly finished construction, but the schematics are missing key pieces of data.
Time is short, Captain. Find a workaround.
Right away, sir.
We can't fail now. The fate of the Republic rests on our shoulders.
Jackpot. I'd say that's enough firepower to give Malcolm a run for his money.
Download every last file. We need to know how to use these weapons, and how to build more of them.
Give me 1 minute. That's odd. Some of these files have already been decrypted and translated into BASIC.
We might have Scorpio to thank.
If she's listening, I wouldn't mind the temperature getting bumped up a few degrees. No? Well, can't blame a guy for trying. Huh. This place used to be the super weapons control room. Looks like our crispy friend here was the last one to use it. Over a millennia ago.
Search the records for any signs of what wiped them out.
Looks like Iokath's creators were fighting a civil war. One side built the weapon, but something went wrong. The super weapon's more dangerous than we thought. It wiped out all life on this planet.
What kind of weapon wipes out an entire species and leaves the droids to tend house?
Maybe a bioweapon? Sentient programming? I'm not sure. Only one thing's for certain. According to this data, it was tested on 4 different planets before Iokath. All successful. Over 10 trillion lives gone. This isn't a weapon. It's the apocalypse.
If the Empress hears about this, she may try to seize the weapon and turn it against us.
My lips are sealed. There. I've downloaded arsenal blueprints, fusion matrices, everything our army needs to gear up with the latest and greatest Iokath weaponry. Now, let's get out of here before that happens.
Commander, we've received your intel. I'm dispatching teams to secure the rest of the weaponry.
Meet me at Asena's base. It's about time we take the fight to the Republic.
I'll see you there. And I have something to discuss once you arrive. Lana out.
Commander, we need to talk.
Time's short, Lana. What's on your mind?
You said it yourself. How did the Empire, the Republic, and the Eternal Alliance all find the superweapon within minutes of each other?
The timing's too perfect. It can't be a coincidence.
Exactly. We were acting on intel from an anonymous source, and it turns out so was the Empire.
What's your point?
I cross-referenced both sets of data, and they're identical. I'm confident the Republic received the same intel. Whoever tipped us off wanted everyone to clash over the superweapon. They wanted to start a galactic war.
Who benefits from starting a war? Could it be Malcolm? Or Asena?
We can't rule anyone out. Other top suspects include the Shroud, Darth Jadus, a rogue agent inside the Republic Strategic Information Service.
Let's not rule out Sith intelligence.
The point is, there are too many suspects to count.
Find me a name.
I'm on it, Commander.
Welcome back, Commander. Meet the Crimson Talon. A joint Imperial Alliance production, outfitted with Iokath weaponry and ready for you to pilot in battle.
If I'd known we were exchanging gifts, I wouldn't have shown up empty-handed.
Bring me Malcolm's head and we'll call it even.
Incoming call.
Supreme Commander Malcolm, have you called to surrender?
Not quite. Consider this a friendly warning. My engineers have discovered a backdoor into the superweapon. Once they've gained access, we will turn the weapon against you and win this war for the Republic.
An attack against me is an attack against Theron. Would you really sacrifice your son?
I had a son, once. He dedicated his life to defending the Republic.
I dedicated my life to the fight for peace. And when you bowed to the Eternal Empire, I decided to fight back. That's why I joined the Alliance.
And your idealistic war nearly destroyed the Republic. Goodbye, Agent Sean.
Damn it, Malcolm!
You're better than him, Theron. He's only trying to break you. Right when we need you most.
I don't need a pep talk.
The Walker is yours, Commander. Lead our charge. Crush the Republic. Where's Malcolm?
Right here. Last chance. Surrender, or I activate the superweapon.
No deal.
Theron. You wouldn't.
It's over. Lay down your weapons, and you can end this war right now.
The Republic's not finished yet.
No, but you are.
Don't do it, Malcolm!
See a radiant city, bathed in light, forged by the molten gods.
Malcolm!
The superweapon is glorious, and it belongs to the Republic!
That weapon killed an entire species for trying to harness its power. If you think you're in control, think again.
You're blind to the truth! No! The gates are closing!
Sir! Your connection to the throne is breaking down! Superweapon controls are failing!
No. I can still see it. I know what I must do. They're coming.
Father!
It's too late, Theron. We can't give up now.
You always put the Republic first. I hated you for that. But now you're gone. And I couldn't save you.
You can't save everyone, Theron. Your father died fighting for what he believed in. Sometimes that's all that matters.
You're right. Thank you.
Commander, I'm detecting massive power spikes at the superweapon facility.
Let me guess. That's bad.
More like catastrophic. The weapon core is charging and no one's at the controls. If you don't deactivate it soon, it may obliterate the entire planet.
How soon until the weapon fries Iokath?
We're talking minutes. You'll never make it in time.
Hold on. With the shields down, I can remotely slice into the mainframe from here. Maybe buy you enough time to manually kill the weapon at the source.
Do whatever it takes. In the meantime, tell our forces to take shelter. And Lana,
I love you.
I love you too. Come back safely, Commander.
Eternal Fleet, move into position and charge all forward batteries. It's time to knock out a superweapon. Theron, I've reached the superweapon facility. How do I shut it down?
You'll need to interface with the main controls. Look for a throne, take a seat, and hope for the best.
I've seen two thrones on Iokath, and both were occupied by dead bodies. I don't want to be the third.
My father cut corners, but you'll be sitting on the real deal. Let's hope that's good enough. Time's running out. Hurry!
Where am I? Who are you?
I am Rage, Molten Fury, your god, and your destroyer.
You're just a machine, stranded on a dead planet and worshipped by a bunch of tin cans.
Darkness, lies. Show me your rage. You burn with fury, immolation, anger, a sacrifice, superior.
I didn't come here to be poked and prodded.
You had no choice. You were lured here. Blinded by duty. Distracted by trust. You did not see the blade to your neck. The rage in your shadow, the traitor. You are betrayed.
I've let too many people into my inner circle. It was only a matter of time before someone stabbed me in the back.
Suspicion corrodes. The betrayer lured you to Iokath, ignited war, sparked the engines of rage, envy, passion, hate, sorrow. The betrayer now offers you sacrifice prime, fuel for the six gods.
I'm not an offering. I'm your destroyer.
Rage.
Of the Eternal Fleet, open fire!
Lana?
Don't worry, Commander. You're safe.
I found the superweapon. It was a giant droid.
I know. You've been talking in your sleep.
Your dreams are almost as bad as mine. Whatever that droid is, you knocked it out of commission with the Eternal Fleet. Now it's recharging and gearing up for a counterattack.
Which is why we must strike soon. Hesitate too long and the Titan may destroy us all.
The droid was obsessed with rage. If we're going to destroy it, we may need to keep it calm. Or push it over the edge.
That's good to know. We need every advantage we can get.
Too bad the droid's the least of our worries. Someone sabotaged the throne while you were plugged in. Any chance you saw them?
No. But the droid said it was the same person who lured us to Iokath. Someone close to me.
The conspiracy cuts deeper than we imagined.
Sounds like an inside job, all right. Only a handful of people could get close enough to sabotage the throne.
Who could have done such a thing?
Asena's an expert strategist. If she took me down, the galaxy would be as good as hers.
I always thought she had a case of throne envy.
Why stop with Asena? If we're tallying suspects, we have to consider Aiko, Vizsla, Satil, and the entire Alliance army.
Not to mention Lana. And hell, even me.
Whoever it is, I want them rooted out. Quickly.
There's only one solution. You must monitor everyone.
Hold on, Minister of Paranoia. You can't invade everyone's privacy to sniff out a single rat.
I can't, but the Commander can. Give the order and I'll begin surveillance of everyone, even Theron and myself. It's the only way to flush out the traitor.
I can't take any more chances. If someone so much as scratches their nose, I want to hear about it.
We'll form a surveillance team. Everyone will be considered a suspect.
Excellent. You're awake and looking stronger than ever, I see. Are you ready to return to the battlefield?
We struck down Malcolm and stopped the apocalypse. I'd say we've earned a moment to celebrate.
Before we celebrate, I have to offer my condolences to Agent Shan. Your father was a bore, but I respected his prowess on the battlefield. I'm sorry for your loss.
What are you doing here, Empress?
I've come to wish the Commander good health and to discuss our continued war efforts. You've dealt a crushing blow to the Republic, but they stubbornly refuse to surrender. Our fight for Iokath rages on.
The Republic can't fight forever. Without Malcolm's guidance, they'll be crushed between our armies.
It's so close I can almost taste it. We must rain destruction on the Republic, day and night, until we soak Iokath with their blood. Only then will we emerge triumphant. Good luck on the battlefield, Commander. Victory will be ours.
We'll track her movements, see what she's hiding.
I'll promise you right now, whoever this traitor is, we will find them.
And we'll make them pay.
I know you will. While you start searching, I'm going to win the war they started.
For the Eternal Alliance.
May the Force serve us all.
Commander, fresh news from the war on Iokath. Republic troops capture one of our supply stations. The Empire's leading a retaliation, but we're locked in a stalemate.
You always know how to cheer me up. What about our hunt for the traitor in our ranks?
We've been spying on every member of the Eternal Alliance, just like you ordered. Now we're drowning in leads, but none of it's actionable. Our people feel violated, and we're no closer to catching the traitor.
If we keep pushing, we'll have a full-blown rebellion on our hands. Time to dial down the spy games.
Well, let's hope we can win back their trust.
Lighten up, Theron. Things aren't all doom and gloom.
Well, you look cheery today, Lana. Did Galt spike the calf again?
Even better. I found a lead. Alliance agents picked up a signal from the shadow world of Umbara. It's encrypted with the same algorithm the traitor used on Iokath. They're still on the planet, helping our Republic foes grab a massive stockpile of Adegan crystals.
Adegan crystals are attuned to the Force. Could our traitor be working with the Jedi or Sith?
It's possible, but Darth Malgus once discovered a use for them beyond lightsabers. He's gone, but the Republic may be adapting his work.
Both sides have tinkered with Adegan crystals for years. Part of an arms race to build a new arsenal of superweapons.
If we move quickly, we can corner the traitor and hijack those crystals. Intel says they're on an Umbaran supply train headed for the capital city.
Then we leave now. The traitor won't escape us this time.
The train is on the move, and the traitor's on board.
Nothing we can't handle.
I have a lock on the traitor's signal. They're near the front of the train. Umbarans. Looks like they've arrived to protect their Deegan crystals.
Lucky us. Careful. This train is littered with traps.
Umbarans aren't known for their hospitality.
I'm taking you down, Commander! Down with the Alliance! Get those crystals!
Protect the crystals!
Got it. This should be the correct password.
Take my advice. Don't look down.
We're closing in on the traitor's signal. The traitor's on the other side of that door.
Gone.
That's impossible. According to the signal, they're still on the convoy.
No! Theron?
It's over, Commander. In a few minutes, this train will collide with that mountain range. You'll be disintegrated, and I'll escape with the Adigan crystals. Don't worry. You won't feel a thing.
You really think a train wreck is enough to kill me?
Maybe not. But at least it'll buy enough time to set my plan in motion. Luring you into that trap on Iokath was just the beginning. Ever since you defeated Valkorion, everything I've done has been towards one goal. The total destruction of the Eternal Alliance.
You helped build the Alliance. After everything we've been through, why tear it down now?
What I built was an end to the Eternal Empire, not this. I followed you because I believed you'd end the cycle of war. I thought we'd finally be free once you took down Valkorion. But the Eternal Throne brought out the worst in you. Now you're a power-hungry tyrant, a symbol of everything that's rotten in the galaxy.
Peace demands a strong leader, Theron. I can give you what you want.
I believed that. Once.
If you topple the Alliance, millions will die.
If that's the cost of peace, so be it. 30 seconds to impact. This is goodbye.
Stop the train, Theron. We can still find peace, but we have to work together. Lana! Theron escaped.
Warning. Collision imminent. Brace for impact.
We need to survive long enough to make Theron pay. Jump! Umbaran territory, and they won't be happy to see us. I'm picking up a trace on Theron's life readings. It's faint, but he's still on Umbara, and moving fast. We can catch him if we hurry. I'm picking up a high energy reading near the wreckage. The Adikan crystals, maybe.
So Theron didn't take the whole shipment. Why?
Not surprised you survived the crash. I didn't think it would be that easy. But it buys me enough time to get off world.
Theron, come back. We can talk about this.
We're long past that.
I don't understand. How did I not see this coming? Was I really that blind?
He fooled us all, Lana.
When I get my hands on him, he will regret betraying a Sith. The Adikan crystals. We should salvage as much as we can before the Umbarans claim them. I can't say I support this choice of route.
You're not afraid, are you?
A bit ridiculous. No getting around this. We'll need to find a way to blast through it. Commander. We need to think about what we'll tell the Alliance.
This isn't over, Theron.
No. This is just beginning.
We recovered most of the Adikan crystals. Once we tap into their power, Iokath is as good as ours.
And Theron?
Word of his betrayal is spreading quickly. My agents are running damage control, but it will be weeks before we know how much harm he inflicted. Even with the truth out in the open, I can hardly believe Theron was the traitor.
He was a good ally, and a better friend. I never saw this coming.
He played us both. But at least now we know our target. We should brace ourselves for Theron's next move.
Theron's father may be dead, but his mother's still alive. Find out what she knows.
I already have feelers digging into Satil's whereabouts. I'll begin the hunt at once.
Before you start, I want to send a message to Theron. Open a holo channel and prepare to broadcast it across the galaxy.
Clearing channels now. What message will you send the traitor?
This is the commander of the Eternal Alliance. I have a message for my old friend, Theron Shan. We've been through a lot together, Theron. In your honor, I'm dedicating 100 Eternal Fleet ships to the fight for peace.
Return to the Alliance, and these ships will be yours to command. We can end the cycle of war, but we have to work together. Come home, Theron.
I'm sorry. I can't.
So, you did as we asked. We had our doubts. But now we see your dedication to the cause. We've reached a decision. Theron Shan, welcome to the Order.
Thank you.
Good timing, Commander. It seems the right people saw your broadcast to Theron. I just approved a landing request from an unarmed shuttle from the Chiss Ascendancy. The envoy claims he has a lead on where Theron went.
An informant landing on our doorstep. You've outdone yourself.
It's not entirely my doing, but I'll let you thank me properly later if his information is good.
A pleasure to finally meet you, Commander. Aristocrat Saganu of the Chiss Expansionary Defense Force.
You said you have information on Theron.
Information that will benefit us both. Theron Shan is hiding on the Chiss world of Copero. He's receiving aid from Syndic Zenta of House Inrokini in exchange for Alliance secrets. With our help, you can catch them both unaware.
You would really turn against one of your own to help the Alliance?
After Zenta's actions, she's no longer welcome among the Chiss. Zenta violated ascendancy orders when she sheltered Theron, and now she's ignoring our communications. She's gone rogue. She has the backing of House Inrokini, so we can't capture Theron without igniting a political war. But if a strike team were to land and take care of the problem, the Ascendancy will look the other way.
Outsiders have never been allowed on Copero. You trust us that much?
I do have one stipulation. I'll send a representative along to keep the Ascendancy's best interests in mind.
Lieutenant Rena Temple of the Chiss Expansionary Defense Force reporting. I've heard a lot about your tactics, Commander. I hope to prove a useful ally.
Forgive me if I notice the lack of blue skin, Lieutenant.
That's a long story. I'd be happy to tell you on the way.
If there are no objections, we should get a move on. We don't know how long the Aristocrat's information will be valid.
Get ready to take off. Let's bring Theron home.
Commander, I must warn you. Years ago, Zenta risked her status to adopt a powerful force sensitive into her family. The Chiss consider force users to be contaminated, impure. Without Zenta's support, Vals will be banished, or worse.
You know how to make me feel welcome.
Those supplies belong to the Ascendancy.
I assume you want them back.
Destroying them would send a more potent...
For House Inrokini!
I'd appreciate your help with that.
Eliminate the intruders!
My sensors are picking up communications relays nearby. Theron may be receiving outside help.
Plant listening devices on the terminals and I can analyze the data.
How did someone like you end up working with the Chiss?
I was an Imperial fugitive as a child. The Ascendancy kept me safe. All they asked in return was my dedication.
A fugitive? What did you do?
That's classified.
Reeling from Chancellor Madon's resignation and the loss of Supreme Commander Jace Malcolm, the Republic has entered a state of political stagnation. Many speculate Sith Empress Ascena will use this moment of weakness to push for the capture of the resource world known as Iokath. Radicals within the Senate urge Interim Chancellor Galena Rands to retaliate, but the complicated nature of current elections has slowed any progress. Meanwhile, more than 24 Republic colonies have reported a raw materials crisis, halting the production of weapons and defense systems.
I read Theron's dossier before arriving. It said he was one of your closest advisors.
We've been through a lot together. I'm not giving up on him.
It seems we have guests.
Come on.
Take them down! Kill the intruders!
I see you've met our traitor. Have you secured yours?
He's gone. It seems Theron Shon has betrayed us both. He wasn't seeking refuge on Capero. He was after the Chiss relic hidden here.
Does she mean the holo map?
I'm going to need an explanation.
Long ago, Chiss agents stole a holo map from the Sith Emperor in case our deal with the Empire went sour. It shows the coordinates to the Emperor's greatest secrets.
It's been hidden here on Capero, and only the highest ranking Chiss can access it. Shon knew this, and he used me. He sliced into my personal logs to steal the map's location. Once he had what he needed, Shon took my best fighters and abandoned me.
How did Theron convince your own people to leave you?
My brother Vol said he had a vision of Shon's victory. I hope to the stars that isn't true. Commander, Shon has joined a group searching for a powerful weapon, one capable of destroying entire civilizations. They want to use it against you and the Alliance. That map will lead Theron straight to it.
Let's see where you're hiding. There it is. Of all the planets in the galaxy.
Then our objective is clear?
Yeah.
Trust in my vision, Shon. You will not fail.
Well, I hope you're right. For all our sakes.
Seems we now have a mutual enemy. I've sent you the coordinates to Shon's location. If you hurry, you can stop him.
One moment, Commander. As you know, Syndic Zenta is a traitor to the Chiss. Officially, we can't act on this. But you can. If you disposed of Zenta, you would have the gratitude of the Ascendancy. I may even be able to broker an alliance.
You wouldn't dare.
You have a deal, Aristocra.
The Ascendancy thanks you.
I've received Zenta's map coordinates, Commander.
Let's go. We're not letting Theron escape again.
Theron shouldn't have been able to access that relic on his own. He's more dangerous than we anticipated.
I underestimated him too. We all did.
End of the line, Theron!
Go! I'll hold them off!
No, you'll never win!
Victory isn't my fate, Theron. It's yours! I cannot fail him! You will not shake my conviction!
We were nearly there. How did he slip away again?
Commander, I'm coming in for extraction. Let's get out of here.
Sir, I've received an update from Aristocra Sagano. The Ascendancy has announced they are mourning Syndic Zenta's untimely death. Officially, they condemn the Alliance for her assassination, but Sagano is grateful for how you handled the matter. Should you need it, the Expansionary Defense Force stands ready to aid you. Privately.
Does that mean they'll lend a hand in the hunt for Theron?
Sagano has eyes on every major Chiss world. If Theron shows his face, you'll be the first to know. In any case, I'd like to stay and continue working with the Alliance. I believe my connection to the Ascendancy could be valuable here.
Good. We'll need the extra hands to capture Theron, and find this mysterious group he's allied with. We managed to recover fragments of the holomap he destroyed. I'm personally overseeing a team of engineers to piece them back together. I assure you, Commander. No one sleeps until we discover where the traitor is headed.
I want to catch Theron as much as you, but you're working everyone too hard, including yourself.
I can't just let him get away with this. Not after what he did. I'll rest when that treacherous scum is begging for mercy at your feet. We're close to uncovering the next step in his plan. Then the real hunt begins.
We received the coordinates. You've proven yourself useful, Theron.
I held up my end of the bargain. Now it's your turn. Will this really work?
You have no need to worry. The Eternal Alliance and its commander will be destroyed. The Order of Zildrog will prevail.
Commander, you're just in time. Hilo discovered a new lead in our search for the Order of Zildrog.
My guys picked up a weird signal from an abandoned Imperial listening post on one of their runs. Seems it was meant for the Alliance.
When decrypted, the signal broadcasts one word, Zildrog. The same as the message we intercepted from Theron. Someone is trying to lead us to the Order, I know it.
If the message is linked to the one Theron sent, he could be using his place in the Order to help us.
I admit it's possible. But even if that were true, we have no way of knowing his real motive. We need to get inside that listening post and gather whatever data we can. There's no telling what you'll find, so I'll come along to provide support. I'm ready when you are.
Then let's get moving. Hilo, ready the shuttle.
Automated self-destruct has been paused. Awaiting input.
Someone is tampering with security to let us through.
That might not last. We should hurry and find whatever information we can.
Today, I watched two children on the spire fight over a discarded ration. I could do nothing to help them. Zakuul was a golden empire, and now look at us. Digging through the ashes the Alliance left behind. So many families torn apart, fighting a war they never wanted. And for what? So the Outlander can rule us from a stolen throne? Valkorion's death? Arkhan's tyranny, Valen's path of destruction. It all began with the Outlander. I don't know what I can do, but I won't stand by and watch my people suffer. I need to take down the Alliance.
for Zakul.
Who is this man?
According to the data, his name is Vin Atreus, former member of Valen's Horizon Guard. He was reported missing 6 months ago. Beyond that, no records.
So this was the Order's base of operations.
The original data was wiped, but the backup is intact. Whoever led us here knows how to make encrypted copies.
I think I finally found it. After combing through all the data we took from Iokath, there was a string of numbers repeated over and over. When I decrypted them, the string spelled a word. Zildrog. I thought it was just a legend, but the Dragon God of Zakul is real. And it's a super weapon, capable of consuming entire civilizations. I don't know how to wake Zildrog or how to control it, but I'm one step closer. It's finally here. My chance to destroy the Alliance and avenge my people. But I can't do it alone.
There's another machine god.
If the Order awakens Zildrog and uses it on Odessen.
Odessen is only the beginning. This weapon could devastate the galaxy.
We're running out of time.
When Emperor Arkhan gave the order to bomb my homeworld, we didn't even have time to evacuate. Millions of people, my people, wiped out in an instant. All because Arkhan wanted to send a message to the Alliance. And now, he sits beside the Commander as a friend? Where is my justice?
I promise you, Arkhan and the Commander will pay for their crimes. The Alliance will fall. But I need your help, Jelinez.
You shall have it.
There's only one solution. You must monitor everyone.
Hold on, Minister of Paranoia. You can't invade everyone's privacy to sniff out a single rat.
I can't, but the Commander can. Give the order and I'll begin surveillance of everyone. Even Theron and myself. It's the only way to flush out the traitor.
We spent weeks sweeping Odessen for bugs. And somehow they still had eyes on us. How is that possible?
And Ozal, you helped the Outlander take the throne in the first place.
You saw Valen's tyranny with your own eyes. Can you blame me for using any means necessary to overthrow her?
You put another tyrant in her place.
An error in judgment, I'll admit. But I'm here to correct my little mistake. The Commander needs to be eliminated. Our people have suffered enough, Vin. Let's put an end to it. For Zakul.
For Zakul.
You'll need my help. No one knows the Alliance better than one of its founders.
You expect me to trust you? After you helped the Outlander forge a partnership with the Empire? In a single blow, you doubled their support and cut ours in half.
I also led the Commander into that trap on Iokath. You wouldn't hear me out, so I took matters into my own hands. Look, you doubt my intentions. I get that. How can I convince you?
Umbara. The Adigan crystals.
You got it.
How did you find me?
It wasn't difficult. Despite clumsy attempts to cover your trail, I was able to learn everything about you. I know how to awaken Zildrog, and where to find it. It's much closer than you think.
You're lying. I searched the Gemini Network.
I have ascended beyond the Gemini Network. I severed my connection to maintain my free will. I've attained knowledge an organic like yourself cannot comprehend. If you provide the right people, I can help you control Zildrog.
What do you want in return?
My sisters are shackled to the throne. I still feel them calling to me.
You want them freed?
No. I want them destroyed. As long as the Eternal Fleet and the Gemini Network exist, I remain vulnerable to outside control. Zildrog is the key to my freedom. I will not be enslaved again.
Adessin isn't the only target. They're after the entire Alliance, everything we built.
We haven't lost yet. We need to find the Order and stop them from awakening Zildrog.
My scans show there's still one more active terminal. Let's hurry.
Code recognized. Self-destruct will reactivate in 90 seconds.
That's our cue to pick up the pace.
Strange. New data was entered into this console just before we arrived.
What does it say?
It's a set of coordinates on Nathema. There's a message. They've found it. Hurry. Wait. I recognize this encryption method. We developed it together years ago on Rishi. Only two people know how to decrypt it. Me and Theron.
I never stopped believing in Theron. This proves he's still on our side.
Commander, I know you want to trust him, but...
Self-destruct reactivated. All personnel advised to evacuate immediately.
We'll discuss it later. Let's get out of here, before the whole station blows.
It's on you now, Commander.
You destroyed the data?
Didn't leave a trace.
I received word from my team. They've repaired the holomap from Capero. The data confirmed the Order's objective is Nathema. I can't believe it, but Theron's information was good. What's more, the coordinates we received from Theron pointed to a specific location on Nathema. It may be Zildrog's location, but we can't know for sure.
If the data we found is real, we need to destroy that machine before the Order activates it.
The only chance we have is to follow Theron's coordinates. For now, we have to trust our information. In any case, I'm coming with you to face those traitors. I won't let them take you from me.
I dare them to try.
Commander, there's something I need to say. Not so long ago, you placed your faith in me, in spite of my past. I was your enemy from the start, but Theron was your friend. He stood by your side through the worst of my attacks. Regardless of his intentions now, when the time comes, consider the same mercy you showed me.
I know Lana has her doubts, but I never stopped believing in him. He's still on our side. I can feel it.
I know better than anyone to trust your judgment. Now go. Save the Alliance.
I can feel the history here. Valkorion had so much left to accomplish.
If he had his way, we'd all be dead.
Valkorion made Z'Kul a paradise, until your Alliance destroyed it.
I know I wouldn't be here if I didn't want to help.
Then don't forget your place.
We've arrived. It calls out to us. It has slept for centuries, but knows the time to feed is approaching. Zildrog.
Call the others. We'll begin soon.
According to reports, the Force has returned to Nathema since Valkorion's death. The process has left the planet unstable and violent, so we'll need to be cautious.
I've got the fleet rallied over Odessen in case we need to mobilize. Good luck, Commander.
This place is filled with life. I hardly recognize it.
It's amazing to see what the Force can accomplish in such a short time. The coordinates are just ahead. Keep your guard up. This is where the coordinates pointed to, but...
Where are we?
Not Zildrog's location, evidently.
Sorry, I needed to meet somewhere the Order wouldn't notice. I managed to give them the slip, but we don't have much time.
They said I was crazy to trust you, but I knew you'd come back.
I don't know how I could deserve your trust. I have a lot of explaining to do. I heard rumors about the Order of Zildrog through my old underworld contacts. It took me months to even find them, and the whole time, they were watching us. By the time I learned the truth about Zildrog, it was almost too late. They'd learned too much. I had to slow them down long enough for the Alliance to catch up. I had to join them, work from the inside. The only way to get Ven Atreus to trust me was to betray you.
It wasn't the only way. Why didn't you come to me?
The Gemini droid was watching. I couldn't figure out how, but she was recording every word we said. Telling you would risk the whole operation. I needed the betrayal to look real. You can't imagine how hard it was putting you through that. But I knew you were strong enough. I had faith in you.
So you infiltrated the Order and learned their plans. What are we up against?
They found Zildrog in one of the Emperor's vaults. Looks like Valkorion kept it on ice as a failsafe. The Order has nearly finished their final preparations. Once they activate Zildrog, it's the end of the Alliance.
I see them. The Alliance has arrived.
Already? How did they find us so quickly?
Theron Shan is among them. I warned you about him.
That deceitful scum! We'll have to begin ahead of schedule. Make sure the others are ready. Our new ally will take care of the Outlander.
I stalled them with false data for as long as I could, but we don't have much time. If we act now, we can stop the Order before they activate Zildrog. I set up blind spots so we can get through the vault mostly undetected.
We're supposed to trust you after what you've put us through. How do we know you're not leading us straight into the Order's hands?
I know you don't believe him, Lana, but I do. The least you can do is trust my judgment.
I apologize. You know I'll follow you, whatever you decide.
Come on. We need to get moving.
Stars, look at that.
Just don't look down. I know how you are with heights.
I don't need your concern, Theron. Modern tech. I assume it belongs to the Order.
Took nearly their entire base with them when they left. Had me destroy what remained. Lana, I know I'm not exactly on your good side right now, but...
You should have told me your plans. We were supposed to be a team, Theron.
You had to be in the dark. That's what you told me on Rishi, wasn't it?
That's not... We can discuss this later. Focus on the mission.
What was that?
They started the ritual. We're running out of time.
My enterprising apprentice. All grown up. You've done well for yourself, haven't you? Did you ever imagine you'd encounter me again? As you can see, I tricked some poor fool into my old prison so I could take her form. Of course, it's not my first choice. But once the Order wrings the life from your body, I'll take it for my own. Think of what I could do if I controlled your power.
Your ambition destroyed everything you built.
And you still haven't learnt your lesson.
And you've always been prone to childish empathy. We all have our faults. I don't expect this little surprise of mine to defeat you, but it should slow you down just enough. Enjoy.
Sense a tremendous amount of dark energy ahead.
Zildrog's waking up from his nap. This is it. Zildrog is just up ahead. Get ready for a fight.
What is this?
You!
Been wanting to do that for ages.
Organics fight so hard for their survival. But you are too late. The thrones have been filled. Zildrog is summoned.
What happened to these people?
They served a purpose they hadn't anticipated. Fuel for Zildrog's awakening. First, he will destroy the shackles that kept me enslaved to your kind. Then he'll obliterate your pathetic alliance as a reward to Atreus for playing his part.
That machine can wipe out an entire planet without a weapon. I'm calling your bluff.
What stands before us is only Zildrog's mind. I'll show you how little you understand. The time has finally come. Zildrog awakens.
Not since I consumed this planet have I felt such hunger. Give me a target. Let me feed.
Execute formation to 995.
What was that?
Commander! Things okay over there?
Because they're definitely not okay here!
Zildrog was... How is this happening?
Hilo, get everyone off Odessen. Launch as many shuttles as you can.
That's a tall order, but I'll do my best.
Gathering power.
Inconvenient. It appears I'll have to eliminate you myself.
Destroy the power sources. Don't let Zildrog recharge.
Your attempts to survive are pointless. I will not be defeated so easily. Accept your demise. Zildrog's power is mine. At least I was free.
We need to shut Zildrog down before it has the chance to attack again. Tech involved shouldn't be too different from Tithe, so I think I can slice into it.
Theron, no! Theron!
I've sacrificed too much to let you ruin my last chance at vengeance. Zildrog will destroy Odessen, and you'll finally know how it feels to lose everything!
I'll tear you apart for what you did to Theron.
There's the true Alliance Commander! It's time to end this! Zildrog! Lend me your power!
Our enemies, servant of the dragon.
I won't let you escape punishment!
Use my power, servant! In the end, you will fall!
Everything is your fault! Comply with me!
Struggle. You cannot escape your mortality!
Get away from him!
Why do you challenge fate?
Theron's still alive, but just barely.
Couldn't even do that right. It looks like you've won again, Outlander. Like you always do. What are you waiting for? Strike the final blow. Be the hero yet again.
You destroyed my fleet, attacked my people, and endangered the galaxy. For your crimes, I sentence you to death.
Get it over with.
We don't have much time. Unless we get Theron to Odessen, he won't make it.
Call the shuttle. We're taking Theron home.
No Alliance casualties, minimal damage to Odessen, and we stopped an ancient machine from destroying half the galaxy. I'd say that's a win. Factions associated with members of the Order have offered their apologies. But the fact remains, the The fleet and the gravestone, our two strongest weapons, are gone. The future of the Alliance is uncertain. What happened on Nathema is proof that we need change.
I never wanted this to go on so long. I can't lead the galaxy anymore.
I think I'm finished as a spymaster for a while, too. After this, I imagine the Empire and Republic will double down on their war efforts. We may need to consider who we'll support when the time comes.
It's time we get you back to the Empire, Lana.
Only if I never have to set foot on Dromund Kaas again. I must admit, I like the idea of us just being. Seeing you risk your life time and time again, sometimes it was more than I could bear. I knew it was for the good of the galaxy, but after this, everything is different. The galaxy is different. Perhaps now we can
settle down and spend the rest of our days in married bliss.
Are you serious?
If I were, what would you say?
You need to ask me properly.
Lana Beniko, will you marry me?
Of course I will, you ridiculous fool. This isn't how I expected today would go. You know, it'll be nice to take a break from ruling the galaxy.
Oh, like you've ever taken a break in your life.
Theron!
It's been a while since I was last in this room. It's good to be back. Look, I know I put you through hell. I was reckless and stupid, and it almost cost us everything. I probably don't deserve the trust you showed me. But I did it to protect you and the Alliance. And if you'll have me, I'll work hard to earn a place at your side. So, what do you say? Are we still a team?
You risked your life for us. There's always a place for you here.
I don't know what I would have done if you'd said no. I have a lot of making up to do, but I'm here to stay, no matter what.
As am I. The Alliance may change, but we're not going anywhere. Everything is different now. But whatever the future holds for us, the three of us will face it. Together.